imagine you're rolling down the road, you got your colors on, it's New Year's Day, and you're almost home. Your wife and kid hear your motorcycle pulling up. Your wife's looking out the window, happy, expecting you to come in. Your son is in the window, happy and anxious that his father's about to pull in the driveway. You're happy you had a great night. You were with your brothers, you're out riding, and now you're home sweet home. And at that very second, now you're laying on the ground trying to figure out what just happened. Why do I feel hot? Why do I feel cold? Why am I having a hard time breathing? Why did everything just go dark? Why do I feel somebody taking my clothes off my back? What's going on? Am I gonna see my wife? Am I gonna see my kid? Oh man, I think I'm dead. What's good, everybody? I'm Danny D'Lo, and this is Danny D'Lo Biker TV. In this episode, we're gonna be talking about Lefty, One Percenter. From the Pagans MC. Now, I know a lot of your mouths just dropped. I have prided myself throughout my career as an influencer on TikTok and on here on YouTube. I prided myself this whole time by never saying a club's name out of my mouth. And I've never put a club's patch on my thumbnails. I prided myself for not doing that because everybody else pretty much does. And me coming from the world I come from, I just don't believe it's a good look. And I personally don't like it. But I really sat down. I'm a month late on this whole video. I really sat down and thought about it. And I'm like, you know, there's no other way for me to do this video properly unless I go against some of my own personal rules. So first and foremost, I want to dedicate this video to Lefty One Percenter, to his wife, to his son, and to the Pagans Nation for losing your brother. I can't imagine that feeling. Actually, unfortunately, I can. So that being said, let's get into it. Welcome back to Danny D'Lo Biker TV. So let's talk about Lefty One Percenter. Those of you that don't know, Lefty One Percenter was a member of the Pagans MC. He was rolling home New Year's Day on his way back home to his family. He was like two doors down or three doors down from his own home. And these five scumbags, these five asshats from the Red Devils MC, decided to follow him home and gun him down like a dead dog, killing him after they shot him off his motorcycle. And while he was laying there fighting for his life, they took his colors off of his back, off of his lifeless body, and the most cowardly act you could ever do. His own son heard the gunshots, killing his father. This hits me personally for multiple reasons. Number one, it reminds me of a brother of mine who was murdered similarly the same way, right in front of his girl's house. My brother Tug. And, you know, it makes me think about him and his situation, you know, and it makes me think about the days when I was in the MC world, you know, any night that could, the same thing could have happened. And what really drives me to do this video is the fact that it was done right at his house. Damn near in front of his own family. And I gotta ask, man, you know, when did we get to this point where this is how we handle our business? Like, this ain't no diss to the Red Devils MC. I'm sure there's many members in that nation that don't like what happened in this situation either. So this isn't like an attack on them. This is an attack on the five pieces of shit that committed this heinous murder. And the reason for me doing this video is I fully expect everyone watching to share this video with multiple people. Let's make this video viral. And it's not about getting me the views or subscribers or any of that BS. What I truly want is for these five scumbags to get the death penalty. I want this to turn into a high-profile case, and I want it to be all over the news, and I want to watch these guys rot in jail and be killed by the death penalty because they deserve it. An example needs to be made on these five guys. This guy right here with the tattoos all over his face, which seems to be a new trend nowadays, and the MC world especially. That scumbag was all over TikTok, making videos and posting videos all the time. Yeah, man, we're looking for the pagans, and, you know, where y'all at? Where y'all at? We're out here. Where y'all at? We're looking for you. And, well, I guess in hindsight, he wasn't joking. He finally found one. And did the most cowardly shit I've ever seen in the MC world. And I've seen some pretty crazy stuff in this world. Excuse me. And, you know, it really resonates in me, man. It really bugs me, man. Because it's like, you know, you got guys like me in Hollywood and Black Dragon, Sosta Ghost. You get so many of us, and we talk about it's not a gang, it's a club. But then you got guys out here like these yahoos that do straight up gangbanger shit. This is no different than back in the 90s of robbing somebody for their Jordan gym shoes. No different than gang violence. So here we are with another good brother dead, murdered. A wife with no husband, a son with no father. And unfortunately, I'm pretty sure this won't be the end of that. And it makes me sad, man. Excuse me again. I have a cold, y'all. I'm sick. It makes me truly sad because when did this MC shit turn into this bullshit? Like, seriously, man. All we ever wanted to do was ride our motorcycles with our brothers, have fun, drink, party, get some ladies, have a good time, and make memories with our brothers, man. That's all it was supposed to be about. Now it's all gotten so serious to the point where there's no fun to be had anymore. Sure, at the clubhouse you're having a good time, but the minute you walk out of there, you never know. You don't know if you're going to jail. You don't know if you're going to get shot, beat up, chased. You don't know. It's not fun no more, y'all. You know, there's many creators out here that, you know, will preach, you know, unity, unification. And you guys have heard me say this once before, that anybody in the MC world that preaches unification has obviously never spent a lot of time in the MC world. This is an alpha male world. It's never going to happen. We're not going to hold hands. We're not going to sing kumbaya. And we're not always going to be friends. We're going to fight. That is what it is. You put 10 pit bulls in the same room, that's going to be a damn problem. That's the world that we've created. This is the kind of world that we're in. But that does not mean we can't coexist. Ultimately, I want to make a peace offering and an idea of why not, instead of retaliating, let's sit down and figure this out with everyone. Ain't none of you gangsters anymore. Ain't nobody running guns. Ain't nobody running drugs. Ain't nobody running women. There's abso-freaking-lutely no reason to fight over territory. The only thing going on right now, it's really starting to look like gangbanger bullshit. I hate to say it, man. It breaks my heart to even say that. But that's where we're at now. It seems like you're just not a respected dude anymore unless you got a bunch of clown-ass tattoos on your face and you run around acting like a half a fool on the internet. Like, that's where we're at, man. And it's sad. It's truly sad, man. I'm tired of watching brothers be killed in all nations. Aren't you guys tired of it? Aren't you tired of burying your brothers? Aren't you tired of watching old ladies crying at funerals? Kids crying at funerals? Family members crying? Brothers crying? Aren't any of us tired of that, man? It's gotten fucking old, hasn't it? I don't even know what to say anymore about the MC world, man, because anytime I come on here, I try to preach about how cool we are and how good we are and the good things that we're involved in and that we're not the people that the society wants to claim us to be. But then you got people like this that do shit that shows exactly that that's what they're not wrong. So where are we left at? You know what I mean? So this ain't no plea for peace. This is definitely no plea for unification. And I totally understand not wanting unity. I completely get it. But there's no reason why we can't coexist to a point where you guys stay over on that side of town. We're going to be over here on this side of the town, and that's that. Stay in your lane, we'll stay in ours. That's the way it should be. But unfortunately, you get a punk that wants to run amok, and all hell breaks loose again. It's been a constant thing. And instead of sitting down and getting rid of that problem child, everybody backs it up and goes with it. So then we end up right where we started, right here. I can't imagine wanting to kill somebody just for a patch, man. And this is coming from a former gang member and a former MC member. I just can't see a reason to kill somebody for a patch, man. I can't. That man had a family. Now you just took him away from all of that. For what? For what? That guy that was all rah-rah on TikTok with the tattoos on his face, talking about where they at, where you guys at? Well, 2,000 of them brothers showed up in your town.
Motorcycle riders caught the attention of drivers and onlookers this morning. This was the scene at the Vance Franklin County line where hundreds of people gathered earlier today. But before they were here, they were in the triangle. WRAL's Leslie Moreno has been working to find out what these bikers are doing here. Leslie.
Well, Julian, the bikers first gathered here in South Raleigh at this shopping plaza. We spoke with several businesses. They tell us this entire parking lot was filled with bikers. Our news crews were here shortly after they arrived, and they just kept coming in. What one witness tells us, they started to arrive at around 10:30 this morning, and they believe there were more than 2,000 bikers. If you take a look at this video here, this is from our Sky 5 that flew over the ride along Capitol Boulevard and continue to track them north. Law enforcement agencies cleared off several intersections and stop signs, stoplights along the route. We also saw hundreds headed north through Raleigh to an area south of Henderson for an apparent memorial this afternoon. They left the area a short while later and were still working to learn what was the reason behind that gathering. However, we did notice the name Pagan on the clothing of several bikers, as you can see there on the video. You may recall a man on a motorcycle was shot and killed on Bayberry Lane in Raleigh earlier this month. A source tells us that man was a member of the Pagan biker gang, and five men charged in his killing are part of a rival gang, the Red Devils. So far, police have not released any information about today's gathering, but employees here in the area we spoke with tell me it was peaceful and they had no problems today.
Where were you? You in jail, stupid. Where were all your brothers that were all rah-rah? They were nowhere to be found either. And I'm glad they weren't. I truly am. Because I don't really, truly, at the end of the day, don't want to see anybody die over this shit. I just don't. I'm not saying I'm against some of the stuff that naturally happens in this world. But I'm not for it either. I want all you to think about this, man. I want you to think about the beginning of my video. Just think about that, man. You're on your way home. You had a great day with your brothers. You're rolling up to your crib. Your old lady, your kids, they hear the bike coming. They get all excited. Dad's home. My husband's home. My man's home. And then they hear the shots. And now they hear the sirens. Now they're outside trying to figure out what's going on. They walk two doors down and they walk down their driveway and they see a familiar motorcycle laying on the floor. They see their loved one laying on the ground bleeding to death. Was it worth it? Was it truly worth it? I'm gonna ask both sides. Was it worth it? So I wanna ask everybody to bow your heads and what I'm now going to call a biker's moment of silence. This is what it looks like when your brothers love you. And I'm sure Lefty One Percenter was looking down on everybody from his cloud with a smile on his face. So bow your heads for a biker's moment of silence.